Hi, I'm Jordan with Eaton Switching Device product line. Today we've got a couple heavy-duty safety switches, and we wanted to make a video to answer a lot of the questions we get about what makes a safety switch service entrance rated. So one of the first requirements for the National Electrical Code for a service entrance switch is overcurrent protection in or immediately adjacent to the switch. So most common, that means you specify a fusible safety switch, put the overcurrent protection, which are the fuses, inside the switch. Doesn't have to be, but if you don't have fuses in the switch, you've got to have overcurrent protection immediately adjacent to the switch. Second requirement is to have a bonded ground and neutral connection. So switch on the left here has a factory installed neutral kit. So that factory installed neutral kit is going to come with a bonding strap or ground or bonding screw, depending on the amperage of the switch, that bonds that neutral connection to the enclosure where your ground lugs are. So once you've installed that bonding strap or bonding screw, you can then apply the service disconnect sticker that comes in the switch with factory installed neutral. Now, if you don't have a factory installed neutral, you can buy the neutral kit separately, which will also come with that bonding kit and that service disconnect sticker. So if you cover those two bases, the only exception then is at 1200 amps, 480 volts, National Electrical Code requires a ground fault protection at that amperage. So in that case, you have to go to our 1200 amp shunt trip safety switch and select the ground fault option. Any other questions on Eaton safety switches, feel free to contact us at flexswitches@eaton.com. Thanks.